Good afternoon, dear children. Today we will see the next part of our reported speech. That is, reported speech, direct indirect speech. We are changing direct speech into indirect speech. So here today we will see interrogative sentence. Interrogative sentence, question mark. Okay. When we ask, that is when the end of the sentence, when question mark is there, those sentences are called interrogative sentence. So, rules for changing the interrogative sentence. As we had seen earlier, how to change the same thing, we have to see, we have to find out subject, object, reporting verb, then the tenses and the person, first person, second person, third person, in this way, and again the tenses. And if that said reported verb is in the present tense, no need to change reported speech tenses. When the reported verb is in the past tense, then we are changing tenses. Okay, you have to keep this in mind. So the same thing is there, only the one thing is there, change of reporting verb. Change of reporting verb is said, if it is said or said to is there, it will come ask, A-S-A-E-D, ask. The other thing is S-A-Y-S, says, says to, it comes ask. And third is, see the difference between, here S is there, but here downside, S-A-Y, say, and say to is there, there is, ask is there, and if in that sentence, suppose, ask and ask, if it is like this is there, there will be no change. What you know, there, if there is, ask, asks or asked, there will be no change. In the reported verb, if there is asked, is there will be no change. As it is, you have to write in the indirect speech. Okay, now how many types of reported questions are there? There are two types of questions are there. One is, you know, direct question. Direct question, that is, begins with WH family. How much water do you have? How many pencils do you have? Where do you live? When did you come? When it starts, that is called direct question. And the other thing is yes and no question. Are you coming with me? The answer is yes or no. When answer is there only yes and no, those questions are called yes and no questions. And the rest question begins with WH family, WH, that. So that is called the direct questions. Okay, then here you have to change the rule. So directly we'll go to our examples. The examples are here, you know, that we will see the examples. Okay, what is that? First one is, okay, what is that? He said to me, okay, again, we'll see all the subject, object and person and all. He said to me, okay, this is the present. R means present tense, you, second person doing it, and here the person is there, my is also here, first person. Okay, then here she asked, R again there, it is there, R is there, means that is a present tense. Okay, and here she says, me is object, do you is there, you is a second form. No, okay. See here, I will take three examples of direct question, three examples of yes and no question. So here we are taking direct question, starts with, you know, see the starting with here, then here, WH. You. Okay, here I have given this, no problem. So this is the W, these two are there and the mix I have given. So we'll start. How we will start then? What you have to change? You have to change the person. Persons change according to subject. The first person is there, it will change according to subject. Second person change will change according to object. And when in that reported speech, if the third person is there, there will be no change. We have to keep as usual. All the types of questions exercise will take. So the first one is there. So what will you come? Say the two. Here say the two. What will come? Say the two. Asked will come. So right there, he asked me. Now we are removing this. We are removing inverted commas. When we are removing inverted commas in direct question, what we have to write? Start with WH only. So he asked me what. So here subject will come first. You is here. You is the second person. Second person changes according to object. Object is here. Me. Me is object. So subject will come I. Okay. So I. R is there. R is in present tense. You have to write here in past tense. So what will come? I was. The rest thing you have to write. Doing with. Okay, now here is the first person is there. Here is a first person is there. First person changes according to subject. First person changes according to subject. Subject is he there. So we have to change with his friends. With his friends. So answer is like this. He asked me what. Okay, no, we have forgot to write. He asked me, right. Well, because here it will not start with if. Here, here. S and no question, there only when we are removing inverted commas, we are writing if or whether. Here only because it starts with directly WH question. So, answer is that he asked me what I was doing with his friends. Very good. We'll go to second. She asked, okay, here they have given, she asked, okay, she asked, okay, now we have seen, pay attention, it is asked. Here is asked. When asked is there, there will be no changing. There is no change. So we'll write directly asked only. She asked. She asked. WH? No, you need to write directly, write with question only. When? Then this will come. They is there. First person, second person, they, that is a third person. Dear children, this is a third person. So, third person will not change. So, you will write here, she asked me, when they, what will come here? Here is our past tense is, were, okay. Were, when they were supposed to come. Supposed to come on. Come. So there will be no change in COME. Come. Go to third. Here I have given S no question, but again we will see the other one. So she says, what is the reporting verb? Says. What will come? Ask. And keep in mind, dear children, as I said, when it is a past tense, then there will be change. Here is a present tense, so there no need to change in reported speech. So what will be the answer? Answer will be this. She says, what will you write? Alright, she says, she says we change it to ask. She asked me, do you know Rohit? Yes or no question. So there you have to add if or whether. So what we will add there? If. Okay. If you, second person change according to object. So here me is there. So I will be here. If I know If I know, Rohi. No, my is not changing. No, this is, we are not doing a, changing into past tense because here is a present tense. Okay, and when this interrogative sentence, when we are changing, you know, when we are changing, so you have to make this a affirmative sentence. That question mark you have to remove, make an affirmative sentence. She asked me if, here we have not written because it directly starts with WH. Here the yes no question is there, so we have written here if or whether. You can write if also, if you, and you can write whether also, both are correct. She asked me if I know Rohit. So three more questions we will take and we'll conclude here.
Let's see third, fourth example. Wait, what is fourth example over here? Okay, again we'll see. See, this is actually, you need practice for this, huh? Here, but all the things I'm taking very basically, but when you do, few examples you do like this way, and other afterward you have to do directly, because in the examination, in this way it will not come, because we are from CBSC, so that this direct indirect speech, that is reported speech, will come in a dialogue form. You have to understand that dialogue and then you have to write, change according to this what we have taught you. Okay, dear children, so practice it more, then only you will be able to write in the dialogue. So in the exam, directly will not come change this following sentence into indirect speech. It will come in dialogue form. So you need practice. Okay, we'll go to fourth example. That is, he asked. Now when is here? Okay, now use second form, come for the meeting. She, here is a she, asked, did. You is a, again second form, pluck the flower yesterday, time denoting. So here is a, yesterday is a time denoting word according to that region. Okay, then again he said to, Lena is object. Again here you is there in second form, I am is the first person, and we can say. So according to that we will change. So how it will change? Okay, now you say ask us. What is the ask us? What will come? Asked us. Okay, asked is there. Okay, asked is there. Us is there, object. Okay, asked. Okay, now here he asked will not change, it will remain same. So we'll write here, he asked us. Will is there, will you come for the meeting? Yes and no question is there. So yes and no question is there. So what will become? Whether. Okay, we'll write whether, whether you is the second form, second person change according to object is as. So what will be there? We will change. In the first lecture I told will change in would. Okay, we would come for the meeting. See here, she asked us whether we would come for the meeting. Now go to fifth example. That fifth example is there. She asked. Again, asked is there. Will not change. Did you pluck the flower yesterday? Yes or no question. So here also we can use whether. Okay, as we have written here, yes or no, if or whether. Okay. So right there, she asked. She asked if whether. Whether I did you pluck the flower, whether I did is there, past tense is there, perfect tense. Past tense, past perfect tense. So what we did here? Had, had plucked. PLU, past tense. PLUCK, we plucked the flower. What will come? Yesterday, time denoting word. Yesterday. Yesterday we change the previous day. Flower, the previous day. Okay, so what will be the answer? She asked whether I had plucked the flower previous day. Plucked the flower previous day. Now, on the last example, that is, he said to me, Lina, do you know who I am? So again, say the two will come, ask. Okay, he asked, Lina, do you? You is a second person change according to object. Object is Lina. What will be there? What will be there then? Lina is girl, so she. So but here we have tried the reported, we have to remove this. She asked Lina if, okay, if she no, past tense is there, no, new will become here, new, who, I, first person change according to subject is he, so what will be there, who he was, because and is there, was will come. So answer is there. He asked Lina if she knew who he was. Here we have taken 5-6 examples on interrogative. In that we have taken WH question also, and a direct question, and a yes-no question also. I think so, with revision, definitely you will come to know. Practice it, dear children. Thank you and have a nice day.